Thank you very much. First of all, I want to say my thanks to the organizers of this event, of this meeting, and for the possibility to present and to speak to very, very interesting topic, branding of the country. For Kyrgyzstan, this topic is very, very interesting and is very, very important, because we have got our independence not only recently, since 25 years, we are a young and new country in Central Asia. And the branding, it belongs to the very important tasks of the government of Kyrgyzstan. Kyrgyzstan was former part of the Soviet Union and was known as a part of the Soviet Union. Now, after the independence, you can understand how important is this for us to make a good branding for the country. And Kyrgyzstan is a very beautiful country, mountainous country in Central Asia. After my speech, we will show you a small film about potential in tourism in my country. So, dear ladies and gentlemen, in a modern world, the successful economic development of the state in many cases depends on the position it occupies on the international level, its status, its rating, and its image. We in Kyrgyzstan regularly ask ourselves how we position us in a globalized world, how we can increase the attractiveness of our country and achieve the development of the creative economy, tourism, sustainable development, and attract foreign direct investors. We must acknowledge that Kyrgyzstan has to spend a lot of time in order to build up its recognizable national brand. We should dispose the negative stamp of a former Soviet Union republic. For development of tourism and attraction of foreign investments, it's necessary to display this outlived image and make an effort to create a new attractive image of Kyrgyzstan. Quite often, it is much more effective to use the existing cultural resources in the country in order to get popularity and support, rather than to waste its limited resources for the building up a new national brand. It is not by coincidence that American researcher Joseph Nye in late 18th defined the ability to exploit the attractive image of a country and the tools that create such an image as a soft power. One of the resources of the soft power is a skillful usage of image technology, the right definition of the targeted layers and mechanisms that will help to generate the expected image of the country. It is clear that the creation of national brand of the Kyrgyz Republic, which would provide a positive perception of the country in the world, will also help us to effectively develop tourism and attract foreign investors. That is why the government of Kyrgyzstan has started to work on building a national brand, understanding that it is not only the specific goods produced in our country, but all the symbols, names, and places of interest recalling persistent positive associations. According to the idea of government, national brand should represent the country as a state that produces goods with utmost quality, provides high-level services with qualified human resources, cultural traditions, natural and recreational resources. Today, Kyrgyzstan is a country with economy in transition. Accordingly, the economic entities in Kyrgyzstan need assistance from the government and from foreign donors, investors. This is especially noticeable in the sphere of small and medium enterprises. More than 70% of total number of small and medium enterprises in Kyrgyzstan are specialized in trade, tourism, services, and intermediation activities. Only 20% represent the industry. The contribution of small and medium enterprises in the GDP in Kyrgyzstan is estimated at about 10%. These figures suggest that the potential of small and medium enterprises is not used to its full extent. There are still enough factors that hinder the development of small and medium businesses in Kyrgyzstan, so the government tries to undertake necessary measures to eliminate the obstacles. It would not go into, I would not go to into mentioning such measures as development of an effective infrastructure, financial support for small and medium enterprises, delivery of a wide range of services and assistance of in various areas such as information, consultancy, financial, and etc. In other words, small and medium businesses still faces various challenges in their everyday life. But among them, one of the key problems is the promotion of their products. The Kyrgyz business society is still insufficiently owns the sales promotional technologies. The standard set in the derivation of the products on the market is advertising, publishing, PR, articles, and different promotion campaigns. With all this, the product itself and its trademark represent only some physical features like taste, smell, color, desk. They have no competitive advantage. In this regard, the existence of a strong national brand would induce the consumer to buy products that were made in Kyrgyzstan. That's the national brand that provides distinctive advantages to a product over similar ones, increasing the value of the goods and the capitalization of the company, increasing the efficiency of advertisement and reducing the cost of advertising. Another problem in our country is the lack of domestic multinational brands. In Kyrgyzstan, we have brands that are recognized on a national level, but not on a global one. One of the reasons is the absence of informative and consultative space in marketing and especially in branding. In 2 days, Kyrgyzstan, competitive market, we can witness the struggle of international brands for their places in the minds of customers, while non-brand products that were made in Kyrgyzstan continue to lose their positions. The experience of the so-called economically developed countries shows that a strong national brand is capable to position a company properly on the domestic and foreign markets, increase the its revenues, contributes to the information and realization of the export potential of the state. A strong, recognizable national brand product not only opens the way for products onto the shelves on the world trade, but also attracts the long-term investments in the country. For a foreign investor, a strong national brand is a very important landmark in business, perhaps even more important than potential risks. Moreover, customers are ready to pay for some items more only because they give some positive emotions or are made in a particular country. I would also like to dwell separately on the impact of the national brand of the development of tourism in Kyrgyzstan. In 2012, the Tourist Association of Kyrgyzstan voted in favor of national tourist logo. The Ministry of Economy was the initiator of this project, which was implemented by the International Business Council with the financial support of the European Commission. This logo consists of three levels: the water, the mountains, and the sky, which are designed in the images of a deer and an argali. When designing a logo, the authors were inspired from the ancient rock paintings in the area of Saymalutash in Kyrgyzstan. The inscription Kyrgyzstan is also performed in the national style. According to the designers, idea of a new tourism logo should reflect the core advantages of tourism in our country. An open and transparent competition was attended by 20 designers who offered more than 90 sketches. At the moment, the logo is used during international cultural, sports, and entertainment events, building a positive image of the country. In general, the information of Kyrgyzstan's brand is built on the basis of national future, such as the people of Kyrgyzstan, revival of folk traditions, and unique culture of nomads. Thank you for your attention. One more addition. Kyrgyzstan is since last year we assessed to European economic to Eurasian Economic Union with 178 million customers, and we hope also it will be have a very good influence on in economical and in touristical further development of our country. And now, maybe before questions, we can see a short film about Kyrgyzstan. Yeah.
Kyrgyzstan. So much to discover.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency, for your speech and for this wonderful video. Now, if you'd like to add more comments to your presentation, or I can open the floor for our audience for questions. Okay, thank you very much. Now, yes, please, I would like to invite you for your questions and comments.
Hi, my name is Joshua Rodriguez, and I'm from the United States. I was wondering, do you think it's possible that with the U.S. base at Manas, that you guys could actually export your tourism through traveling soldiers that are coming in and out of the transit area?
I'm not sure that I have got your question fully. What do you mean with U.S. state base in Manas?
In Manas, there's an Air Force base there. Yes. That's a transit base. So yes. I was wondering, as far as promoting Kyrgyzstan kind of farther than Central Asia, you think it's possible to actually kind of export your culture through the military bases there, since, you know, they'll be going back to the U.S. and they'll be talking about how, you know, how wonderful Kyrgyzstan is.
We have no military U.S. base, transit center base in Manas, but it was not defined for stimulating of tourism. It was a contribution of Kyrgyzstan for the fights in Afghanistan. It was our contribution for to this very important international task to fight terrorism. It cannot be combined with transit center or military base. Tourism is more freedom and more. It was not based in an airport of Manas. It was not in that area where are coming tourists from the world, maybe.
Yes, question coming. Hello. Please. Oh, you don't have question? Okay. Here, where we have a question, please. Can I ask you to raise your hand? Yes, thank you.
Hello, I'm Saskia from Bolivia. I just wanted to ask you, how are you promoting your national brand outside to the foreigners, and who are the market that you are more interested in reaching?
Thank you for the question. We are using it in every possibility that we are outside officially as a delegations our touristic companies, they're using it very intensive. So every possibility we can make our promotion on this way outside. We use such very good places, touristic places and conferences, and like ITB in Berlin and in other places in Asia also. So it means, and we hope that with the time, after several years, we will be known under this logo as a country. It's very, very important. We are not big nation, but the country and the people very, very interesting, very, very beautiful, and for tourists.
Yes, we have next question.
Hello, I'm Vladimir. I come from Slovakia. I have just a very small question. What are you considering is your biggest advantage in compared to other countries around you? Like, because we saw yesterday and also today very nice and interesting videos where it was introduced countries. But what are you recognized as your strongest point? Because in my opinion, you are in the middle or very in a close relation with Europe as well, like with Asia. And can you introduce another advantages of your country? Thank you.
Oh, yes. Every country has some specialities, and it's known what would be for Kyrgyzstan. The surrounding countries, our surrounding countries are also very interesting. But I think, what can I think for Kyrgyzstan? We have high mountains, very, very beautiful nature, and we have Kyrgyz people, our nation, which are the people of Kyrgyzstan, which are very open-minded, friendly, and we have beautiful lakes, mountain lakes. We have here so much to discover, and discover Kyrgyzstan, where maybe it's a key point. Kyrgyzstan is a small country in Central Asia, which you can discover, and I'm sure you will discover it on the very, very positive way.
If you allow me, my name is Askhat Raskulov. I'm counselor of the embassy. I would also like to expand this point of view that we are also trying to promote the best, in the best way, our economy, to show that we are ready and open for modern economy rules and markets. And we have, for the last years, we have introduced a lot of institutions and mechanisms where the foreign investors can come in and invest with a very or at a zero level bureaucracy, and to have a very good output, because we are trying to introduce the so-called regime of a single window. So these are the some of the peculiarities, but sure, this topic could go on and on, but this is our key point for the time being, to be open, to attract more investors, and to promote the democracy and rule of law in the country.
Thank well, thank you very much. We need to conclude now, but first of all, I'd ask everyone to please help me in expressing our sincere gratitude to the Ambassador, His Excellency, Ambassador Erines Otorbaev.